Welcome to Psychic Sunday. This is Reverend Care T, and start your week with a spiritual tune-up. Now, this week we are at the final lesson of the Chakra Basics for Empath series, lesson 8 of 8, and today we're going to talk about the crown chakra. First, let's do a chakra review for all of the chakras that we've covered so far. First up is the root chakra, and the acronym is ASS because that's where it is located at. It has to do with abundance, stability, and safety, ASS. Its associated color is red, but just like every single chakra that we're going to talk about, you need to be open to whatever you experience here, because each person experiences something slightly different than others, and that's okay. That's the way we are designed. The emotions of the root chakra are safety, comfort in the world as a whole, and feeling taken care of. The sacral chakra is located a few inches below the belly button. It has to do with emotional stability, your dominant vibration or emotions, relationships, passion, creativity, and focus. Its associated color is orange, but like the root chakra, be open to whatever you experience here. The solar plexus chakra is located right below the rib cage, and it has to do with worthiness, feelings of empowerment, self-esteem, and how well you are going after your dreams, so the actual action steps involved. Its associated color is yellow. The emotions are confidence, a sense of power, and feeling connected to the self. The heart chakra has four different states: open or closed, and active or inactive. So you can be open and active, which means you are actively giving to others because you want to make the world a better place. Active but closed means that you are helping others, but for some other carrot on the stick, for some other motivating factor. You don't care if it makes the world a better place. Open but inactive means that you have the desire to make the world a better place, but you are not acting on it. And inactive and closed means that you aren't interested in helping others or making the world a better place, and you're not doing anything to help others. The throat chakra is located in the throat area. It has to do with communication, effective self-expression, and connection with your personal truth. Its associated color is blue. The brow chakra is located in between the eyebrows, about an inch up on the forehead, and it has to do with psychic phenomena, intuition, and how well you are listening to the universe. Its associated color is purple or indigo, and just like every other color and every other chakra, don't get into a fight about it. Whatever you experience is fine. The crown chakra, the final chakra, is located on top of your head, at the crown of your head, and it has to do with your sense of spirituality and your connection to source energy and the divine. Its associated color is white or violet. Whenever this chakra works well, you will experience miracles on a regular basis. And in case you're not familiar with the definition of a miracle is any time fear is transformed into love. Anytime fear goes to love, that's a miracle. You feel like a full partner with the universe. You have a love of God, universe, or source energy, whatever you choose to call it. You know on a deep level that you are a spiritual being having a physical experience. You have ease when praying or meditating. You have a healthy pineal gland and a deep sense of peace and happiness. And finally, whenever you look at this chakra, if you get visuals, it will be a vibrant white or violet color. It will look whole and complete. When this chakra needs a little bit of love and light and comfort and care, you'll experience infrequent miracles or no miracles in your life. So this means that you've got a shit ton of fear in your life and it's hard for you to connect with love a lot of times. You feel as though the universe and God makes decisions without you, and you feel left out of the decision-making process. There is a lot of anger at the universe, God, or source energy. You feel like a physical being who occasionally or rarely has spiritual experiences. You find it difficult to pray or to meditate, and you have a poorly functioning pineal gland. You get frequent migraine headaches, depression, and have neurological issues or brain fog. And if you are a type of person who gets visuals, whenever you look at it, it will look dull or it will have holes. So if you are an empath, which I'm assuming you are because you're watching a video specifically for empaths, this is how to help align this chakra by using your gift of empathiness, which is a word that I like to make up. So this is very similar to the brow chakra, if you remember that. You want to use a power pose. The Victorious pose is what I use. If you're unfamiliar with the power poses, there will be a link right below this video where you can download the PDF I made all about the power poses. And the Victorious pose is the one that I use. And to do this, you have your arms upstretched above your head, and your feet are about shoulder width apart. And you're basically celebrating life. Whenever an athlete triumphs in some way, you will see them in this particular pose. They have their hands up above their head. Their head is facing upwards towards the heaven, and they are in a strong stance. Now, I use this with my palms open, and I focus on my breathing. So, you want to focus on your breathing for a minute or two, or until your arms get tired. And then, once you're relaxed, you want to lower your hands to about 45 degree angles from your body. So, it's down by your sides, but it's not resting against your legs, and your palms are still open. So, you're welcoming the universe as a whole. The universal experience. Your chest is out, your shoulders are relaxed back and down. And you imagine yourself receiving the energy and love of the universe as a whole in this state. And if there's any extra information that wants to come through, it is welcomed in this state. Allow yourself to connect deeply with who you really are, which is a non-physical being who's wearing a meat suit. You are inside a human body, you are not the human body. And once you feel this recognition of the truth, allow it to percolate throughout your being and allow yourself to relax and go about your day. And this really is how you let your crown chakra get healed through simple body changes. And that's your gift as an empath. But you, since you're an empath, you can shift your body in subtle ways, and it changes the flow of energy in your body very easily. That's your gift, and it's wonderful because you can have wonderful things happen in your life. Now, if you have any extra tips, leave them in the comments. And if you loved this video, make sure you share it with your friends. Thank you for watching, and if you would like a free chakra meditation, visit www.spiritualmechanic.com. I look forward to seeing you next week, and have a lovely day.